You are watching DHTV from California State University, Dominguez Hills.
Greetings and welcome to ART323 Late European Art. In this short video, I want to introduce myself. I'm your teacher for the semester. Talk a little bit about the scope of our course and some housekeeping details. My goal is that after you've completed, finished watching this video, you feel ready to roll and you understand how this course format is going to work. My name is Kirsten Ellsworth. I have a PhD in the history of art from Indiana University in Bloomington, Indiana. I have taught art history at Dominguez Hills since 2009. I came here in 2009 as a part-timer, and then I was very fortunate to go on to the tenure track in 2014. I'm also the art history advisor in the Department of Art and Design. So if you take this course and think, oh, I might want to minor in art history or major in art history, if you're already a major or a minor, I'm the person you need to communicate with about your course selection, anything, job ideas, internships. I'm really excited to help you move on with your interests in art history. So let's talk a little bit about the scope of this course called Late European Art. That's a very broad label, but the positive side of that is we can talk about many movements. I know a lot of you chose this course because the Renaissance is a significant component of the course, but we also have the Renaissance in Germany to talk about, the Baroque in Italy, the Baroque in Spain, the Baroque in Peru, Rococo, Versailles. There are many developments in the history of what we call Western art that we will cover this semester. And that material, that Western art basis for the history of art, is essential for art historians to know. And also, I'm hoping that you will find a lot of interesting works of art to look at and some ideas that you probably are aware of but may not understand came from this very important period, 1200 to about 1650. Those are the basic dates of this course. Let's talk a little bit about some housekeeping details. And I know you're thinking, what do I do in an online course? How is this going to work, etc.? I want to try to make it all as easy as possible. So with that said, the first thing I want you to do after you finish watching the video here is to go to the Blackboard page. Everything for this course will be found on the Blackboard page. And the first thing I want you to look at is the syllabus. The syllabus contains course policies, grading scale. It also contains the graded assignments for the semester, the list of things we will do and that will be graded. Please familiarize yourself with what kinds of graded assignments we're going to have. And then the last pages of the syllabus are the schedule. And I want you to go immediately to those pages and look at week one. I've arranged the course in weeks, and you will always need to go to the syllabus and find week one, week two, week three, and so on, and find what you need to do. In addition, I am really interested in questions. As a teacher, I think having everyone, including myself, pose questions and debate questions makes the level of knowledge just rise. And to that end, I have a link on Blackboard called Questions. The minute that you have a question when you're reading or when you're looking at the artworks or watching a video, would you please go to the questions section and post your question? I will be monitoring that section actively, the questions discussion section. And I want all of us to be looking at the section to see what kind of questions your classmates are asking and to see your own questions answered. My only caveat, okay, is that you try not to repeat a question that's been asked and answered to your satisfaction. And so that we don't have, you know, a bulky section there of questions. But I really want you to feel and take advantage of the fact that this is an interactive course. Yes, we're in an online environment, but it's interactive, and your questions and your opinions, they really matter, and I want everyone to feel as though we're a group, okay? And you'll see some other activities during the semester that I've designed to try to make that work even more. So, the other topic I should raise before I set you loose on week one is office hours. Those of you who are on campus or near Dominguez Hills, you are encouraged to come to my in-person office hours. I have an office in LaCourte Hall, room B, as in boy, 112, and my office hours are listed on the syllabus. Some of you, however, may not be able to come to campus, and for that reason, our office hour space for this class really is email. And my email address is printed on the syllabus. I try to check email and respond to email in less than 24 hours. Many years ago, someone told me, one habit of a successful person is responding to emails in under 24 hours. So I do try to do that. So that means if you email me and you don't hear from me, make sure you don't have a typo in the email address, because I really try to honor that rule. And I could also set up a Skype appointment or a Zoom appointment with anyone if email doesn't cut it, or I can also speak to you from my office on my phone. So I just want you to know that office hours are very flexible, and all the forms are available to you this semester. Okay, with this introduction, we have started the class. So once you log out here and you check the syllabus, you please jump into week one activities, and I really look forward to working with you this semester. Thank you.
You are watching DHTV from California State University, Dominguez Hills.